only one in tape. And it's all the cross stroke.
All right.
Yeah, it's super cool.
It's really early?
It's really early.
Yeah, because they built it like a cement thing on there.
Yeah, no, it's, well, yeah, because that's, you know,
that,
it kind of came from that era, right?
Right,
right, so they're converting over.
Do you know what year this is?
No, I don't. You can ask John. The guy down there, he owns it. I don't know.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's super cool.
I mean, it's got everything just like it was.
Yeah.
Like, fly ball governor.
Look on a belt. Drive
fly.
Floor, you know? Yeah.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
Yeah. It's super cool. It is super cool.
Well, you only have cool engines, huh?
I don't know about that.
I don't know. Is these all yours?
No, this belongs to Dave Kessler. He lives in Harold, but he's not here today, so my buddy and I, we're kind of going in. The 10 horsepower standard. What's that?
What about that early engine that looks more like a steam engine?
Oh, that, yeah, I made that.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. It's a,
So it's a hybrid or a Frankenstein engine?
Well, yeah, I guess you could call it that. It's actually kind of modeled after an engine that Atkinson made in about 1892.
Yeah.
It's called the Atkinson Utility Engine. It was a closed crankcase, but the cycle is based on the same
cycle.
Yeah.
I know. I